that looked at the state of the American voter. Tell people what that story, what the thesis of the story was, and what the debate was internally over the headline. I found it a rich and interesting debate.
Well, it was a story that I encouraged to be written. A lot of times stories generate from people's rants, editors' rants, my rants, your rants, things that were that are striking us in the news that we're ranting about. And we're like, hey, why don't we get somebody to write this up? One of the prerogatives, reason that being an editor, it's got its compensation, so we can make people write up things that we want seen. Alex Burns wrote up one of my rants, which was looking at some of these polling numbers that have been out recently. You've mentioned them already at different times on the show, Jim. The results from Mississippi showing a majority of Republicans think that President Obama might be Muslim. Well, it's not true. That's just wrong. Some of the concern about how come he doesn't do something about gas prices. Like, well, the president can't really control gas prices in a complicated global market. To me, some of these poll results, they just seem stupid. So I asked Alex Burns to say, why don't you do a piece looking at the question of whether voters are stupid, and a lot of the things that they say in these polls are just plain stupid. Alex warmed to the assignment, and he wrote this. Actually found a number of pieces from pollsters who say, yeah, that's the first thing you learn as a pollster. Voters are stupid. They didn't mean that literally, but it meant that, look, often they're expressing their opinions in a context of ignorance. They don't really understand the issues, although they're happy to pop off if a pollster invites them to. So you do get some results that seem stupid, even if the voters themselves actually aren't stupid. Anyway, he wrote this good piece. We put it up on the site. Some people thought it went a little too far. It seemed too much like a rant. Craig Gordon, who's been on the show, Danielle Jones, our web editor, you could tell they were a little uncomfortable with the piece. Like, wow, are we really pushing it too much? So they didn't want the sharpest headline. The sharpest headline would have been, are voters stupid? Or if you wanted to be even sharper, you could make it not a question, just switch the order of the verb. Voters are stupid. And the piece would have probably supported that. I think instead we want something, you know, a little more neutral. Do voters understand the issue, or what do voters know, or whatever. The debate was whether to go with the sharpest possible headline or a more muted one. I think you and I were in the same place. If you're going to say something, you might as well go all in and go with the most provocative headline. But everybody decides to, you know, occasionally hedge bets. I feel I won this debate in part because we did get a picture of Forrest Gump to accompany the story. Forrest Gump, in this case, representing the sort of ignorant voters out there who are saying these wacky things in polls.